Alright guys, welcome. Let's see how to make a Nike tag commercial in Photoshop and Illustrator. It's a very easy tutorial, so stay tuned till the end. Alright guys, let's start. Now as you can see, we have a reference image in front of us. This reference image can be drawn on paper, or you can digitally also just sort of trace it with a digital pen or stylus. But I have taken a photograph of a paper and I've drawn it with a pencil on paper. So let's start. First of all, we will create a new layer on which we can do the tracing. We have locked the other two layers. This was the first attempt I made. This is something like this. But let's make a new one so we can make it again. Let's zoom in and start the work. So I will be using a pen tool because it's easy for tracing purposes. So we start the tracing. We will not have any fill, but we will have a black stroke. So let's start. Something like this. Till here. And now we add some anchor points so that we can actually blend it with the lower portion to create a wing-like structure when we create lines between them. So continuing. Now we delete the anchor point and continue. So we can use this as a straight line. And curve this one. We can extend it. This looks fine. Alright, let's make another stroke. Like this. Now we should add some anchor points in between so that we can edit the paths more flexibly. We can add one here and one here also. And let's make the lines as per the reference image. So we start here. This. We go on till here. Bit curve. Let's make the second line and then we will blend it together. Now we should have a fading kind of effect to symbolize a wing kind of structure. So we will use some stroke properties like this, so that it creates a thin line, a variable kind of line, and then we can blend it using the blend option. So wing kind of structure can be created, and then we can move around the
points. As per your preference. You can have till here. It looks better than before. And now we can add some lines here also. So like this. Let's keep it here. And then the second line. We should add some more anchor points just to edit the closeness, the proximity here. So we can add one here. And then we can have the path selection to run a bit around. So I did this one also. So create some anchor points on this. Like this one. And the selection tool. So you can play with the anchor points. And this is a must know skill when designing logos or any kind of graphic design, that you should know how to manipulate, because you can't draw the right the first time, and you need to have the ability to edit once your design looks a bit pale or a bit more jagged or somewhere, so you can edit your artwork the way you want. And you can do that by moving around the anchor points. Now we can edit the strokes of it. So we can have this kind of stroke, like this kind. So it has a thicker stroke here and a very thin here. And if you want, you can blend it. Now you can see that it is a bit more dense kind of structure, so you can separate it out. So you can select it as a whole and move it around. Using the path tool, you can just move the anchors a little bit. This looks a bit more smooth than before. Later we will see how to add some gradient into it, so it really fades out into the white background and it will look nice. Now we can also extend these two anchor points. This one to sort of converge. Okay. Move it out like this. Sorry. You can drag these two down like this. So it is a bit more cleaner. And now we can add some more lines to it. Take the pen tool and draw some lines. You can edit the stroke also. this looks fine. And now you can blend it. You can also select this and then try to blend. That would be bad. This is a bit more extruding outwards, so we need to edit this. So we move the anchor point when the lines start to arrange themselves in a much better way. So here it is fine. Now we need to edit this also. So we'll keep it here. Now it looks a bit good. Sort of wing kind of effect. Same effect we can add here also. So taking the pen tool and drawing some lines. Now edit the stroke. This looks fine, and then the regular blend option. Now this is also extruding, so you can play with the anchor points. This looks a bit good, but you can shift this one also a bit downwards. Can also shift this one. So it looks somewhat better than before. Now you can add some gradient into it so that it looks a bit more fading into the white background. So keep the stroke and go to the gradient tab and just click on the space below this big rectangle. So the slide has come out. First you have to select where you have to add the gradient and click. It adds the gradient here. Now you can add more sliders as per your convenience. Edit the smoothness of the gradient. Let's see how this looks. So it looks a bit more refined. Let's add a black background so that we can see the gradient more clearly. Let's keep it underneath the layer. We can fill it with black. We can hide the reference image and see what is going on. Now we can select this and add some gradient to it. Click here. You get a type of this. Now this black color you can take yellow or some kind, such that it has a more energetic type of look. Same with this. We add the gradient. So, more energetic kind of stroke is this. Same with here and with this. Let's edit this one also. So we can have some yellowish kind of thing. It's a bit more visible that way. It looks much better. Now we can add the text of Vaporfly. Let's type in. Let's see how it does. Kano is good. And then we can have a white fill for the time being. White fill. then move this text around and try to fit it with this. This seems good. So you can see that it is giving them more of a commercial kind of look. You can edit this also. This is not as good as work as you can do on your own, but this is just a tutorial, a simple kind of tutorial. You can see how the commercials are designed. They sort of capture the theme of their lineups, apparel lineup or shoe lineup. So zoom means that it must be a concept of speed. So speed is like some kind of blur kind of thing when you're moving fast, or wings kind of thing. So you can add it in your design and make it more energetic, or make it look more appealing or bright. You can use bright colors, or you can use simple solid colors also, but gradient looks better. You can edit this also. So this looks better. Now this stroke is a bit more thick. You can add some kind of with this one. You can thicken it in the opposite direction. Covers the space which we have left here, and we should add some more anchor points here. So selecting it, grabbing the pen tool, we add the anchor point, just drag it down. This looks better. Vaporfly, and then we can add the X part also, so hiding this black there. And this is actually Vaporfly, so one extra V is there. You can edit it. Let's see, we'll shift it a bit so we can have it right here. Now for the time being, let's hide this layer and this one too. Let's see where the X can come here. Either you can use a white stroke. White stroke would be good. Fill it with white, and then you can just duplicate it and rotate it to save time by reflecting it along the vertical axis. Sure. You can move it around. So it looks a bit more like a poster, or a commercial poster you can say, and you can add the Nike logo here. So that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial, and please share it with others so that they could also learn. And like this video, it would help the YouTube algorithm to recommend it to other guys. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.